How do you teach math effectively to your children if you don't feel like you're good at math? What if your child is behind grade level in math? When does my child need to take pre-algebra? And what do I do if my child hates math? I'll answer these questions and more in this video, which is all about teaching homeschool math for grades K-8, no matter what curriculum you're using. I'm Jenny Phillips, the founder of The Good and the Beautiful. So we're gonna jump right into the first question, which is, am I really qualified to teach math as a homeschool parent, especially if math is not a strong subject for me? This is actually a question that a lot of parents have. Many parents feel that math is not their strong subject or their strong point, and they don't remember math from their own school days. But studies have shown that despite the parents' level of education, homeschoolers tend to excel academically. Even though you may not have experience teaching math, a good curriculum designed specifically for homeschoolers will guide you and your child effectively through every lesson. You don't have to remember what you learned in elementary and middle school, but you should keep this in mind. If the average fifth grader or an eighth grader can pick up the math concepts, you as an adult can pick up the concepts too. It's totally fine to learn along with your child. Honestly, you don't need to view yourself as your child's only teacher. As a homeschool parent, you can actually view yourself teaching with much experience because your curriculum is the teacher too. Effective homeschool curriculum like the award-winning Simply Good and Beautiful Math is created by experts with years of experience, but also by homeschool parents who know exactly what support you need. Curriculum for public school is completely different than homeschool curriculum. Yes, it might be hard to teach your children with a public school math course book, but a good homeschool curriculum takes on more of a teacher's role. You, who loves the child dearly and knows the child more than anyone, and your incredible homeschool curriculum, who guides you through exactly what to teach effectively, are a powerful combination. Also, it is good to remember that your child is also getting the amazing benefit of doing math one-on-one with you instead of 20 or 30 students in a classroom setting. This allows you to quickly identify any areas in which your child needs help. And even if you don't know the answers, you can figure it out together. You can also slow down or speed up to meet your child's needs. So another common question that I get a lot about homeschool math is, what do I do if my child is behind in math? For example, if they are taking math 2 or 3 in fourth grade. Or what if we started math in the middle of the school year? How do we catch up? My math team and I believe that being somewhat behind in math in elementary school is not a concern. Math continually builds, so there are opportunities to move faster in the future. It's more important to have a strong, solid math foundation. And with homeschooling comes the freedom of flexibility. When students start to feel more confident, and if math is going well, they can easily double up on lessons or consider doing a little math on Saturdays, or you can go into the summer doing math only 2 to 3 days a week until you're caught up. Also, some students may be able to skip certain lessons or portions of lessons or review if they have already mastered the content. So this leads to the question, where does a child need to end up at the end of eighth grade in order to be ready for high school math? Pre-algebra is most commonly taken in 7th grade or 8th grade, though some students take it in 6th grade and others wait until 9th grade. There is no right or wrong decision. The choice is a personal one, but it's important to consider future math courses and your state's requirements. This is discussed in more detail on our blog, which is linked below, and we also discuss this in our How to Homeschool High School Math video, which is also linked below. So here's another question I hear. What do I do if my child hates math? The first thing I would suggest is to model a good attitude yourself. Be excited about math. Don't allow a negativity surrounding the subject to creep into your home. When talking with your spouse or friends, don't say things like, "Oh, I always hated math as a child," or "math is the most difficult subject to get through." Children really do pick up on those things and can develop a dislike of the subject before even really giving it a chance. Talk about the real-world applications through your day. Math describes so much of the world around us. Use the real-world applications shown in the videos or course book as a jumping-off point for conversations. Also, show your child that you are willing to adapt lessons to make the lesson work better for them. If your child is overwhelmed, don't have them complete all of the problems in one sitting, or spread the lesson out over 2 days. Maybe just talk through some of the problems, and your children don't always have to do every problem or every review problem, especially if they're already solid in the material. And I should also add how important it is to make sure your child is on the right course level. If they are behind or above their level, it can be too hard or not challenging enough, and that could be causing the trouble. And honestly, some kids just have trouble being totally self-directed. And they might need you to sit down with them and do more of the math with them, or they might need to have a break in the middle of a lesson. Keep this in mind as well. If your child struggles with math, I think it's important to validate your child's struggles. Let them know that you are on their side and you are there to help them learn. It's important to be patient. Your relationship with your child is the most important thing. And when they know that you are there to support them, they will be more willing to make an effort alongside you. But I will say that there are just certain subjects that some kids really will resist, despite your best efforts. Recently in our home, I found a method that works for us to help avoid resistance to math lessons, but this only works if the child is on the right level, but just is being lazy or is in a bad habit of procrastinating or not working hard. So I put on a little whiteboard 3 different times that the child can finish math. If the child finishes math by the first time, which is really reasonable, there is a special reward like extra recess time, and there are no consequences. If they finish at the second time, they don't get the reward, but they don't get any consequences. If they finish at the third time, they get a consequence like having to do an extra chore. And with this method, I don't have to nag. And after a couple times of my children testing the boundaries and seeing that they're really there, they actually don't complain anymore and just do the lesson. And I have trained my children to let me know if they are feeling overwhelmed, and I will always come and help them through it. We don't have to just think, I cannot teach my child math, they just won't do it. You can problem solve, and we can do all things according to our family's needs and situations. There are solutions, and if we pray about it and study it and ponder it and try different things, we will find ways that we can teach our children math and even help them love math. So that is it for this video. Check out the links below and make sure to catch our upcoming videos for more ideas and support for homeschooling and finding joy and growth in this one beautiful life we've been given.